And now we will talk about erroneous thinking. So belief perseverance occurs when, even after a specific belief has been discredited, people continue to believe. And this is really well illustrated by this 1954 doomsday cult. So this cult believed that because people had sinned so much, that God was going to send a great flood to cleanse the earth. But if they prayed hard enough, at midnight, a UFO would come to pick them up. So they are praying, and it's getting closer and closer to midnight, and they think the UFO is coming, and then midnight comes, and the UFO still isn't there, and then it takes more time, and the UFO still doesn't come, and finally, there's no UFO. So what do they do? Well, if they believe that they were wrong, then that's really going to shatter their belief systems. So instead, they end up believing that they prayed so hard that God saved the world, decided to spare the world, and didn't send the flood. So even though a specific belief relevant to their religion had been discredited, they continued to believe that they were correct. Negativity bias occurs because people really pay attention to negative information, and it influences them more than positive information. So here's an example. Here's a scale, and it measures how happy you are. And here you are walking around at kind of a normal happiness level. And then you find $10 in your pocket, and you're like, "Woo, this is great. I have a free 10 bucks. Fantastic." And then you go back to baseline. And then, let's say a month later, you get a $10 fine, and you lose $10. Well, that fine is going to upset you more than the amount of happiness that you would have gotten from finding that $10. So the negative information and the negative experience has a larger influence on you than the positive information, the positive experience. So this difference is greater than that difference. So what we're looking at is not, you know, that negative things make you more sad than positive things. It's the change from baseline. And there's a greater change from baseline for negative things than for positive things. So optimistic bias says that you believe that you are more likely to have positive things and less likely to have negative things happen to you compared to the average person. So if I were to ask everybody in this class, how likely are you to get married and stay married compared to the average person? Pretty much everyone in the class would say, I'm more likely than the average person in this class to get married and stay married. But that is simply not possible, because there is going to be an average, and some people have to be at average and some people have to be below average. But everybody says, no, I'm more likely than the average person to get married and stay married. So that can also occur for negative things, but the point is, it's not mathematically possible for everybody to have a better than average chance, because somebody has to have an average chance.